So welcome everybody for being part of today's session on Sunday. I know sometimes it becomes difficult to be, to join in spare time on Sundays, on weekend, but that's what the need of the hour is. If you want to add on some value to your career, you have to learn something, then weekdays are the days when you have the ample amount of time in order to learn something. Otherwise, weekdays are full of other little stuff. So today we're going to start with Google AdWords. For some of you, like I said, it's going to be a refresher, and some of you, it's going to be the very first time. I hope most of you are aware of internet marketing, the search engine marketing perspective. When we do a search on Google, let's say if I type in a keyword, buy iPhone 6, the search results which come off all the websites, these are the non-paid ones, which I've already taken, the organic listings, and these are the these are the paid ones, and these are the non-paid ones, right? The paid ones are the ones which we're going to start making today. Make sense? Are you guys all with me? Dhruv, Dipankar, Lena, Nitin? Yes, okay. Thanks, Dhruv. So, right, the way we're going to... Thanks, Dhruv. Thanks, Nitin. Thanks, Saurabh. Just for letting me know that you're... Lena, are you also there? And Chinmay and Dipankar, are you guys able to listen to me? Okay, thanks, Lena. So the very first thing, guys, it's just some basic information. I'm skipping these slides. And how does it all start? When we do when we do internet marketing, we first of all, we need to have a website. There should be a website which we should have. Let's say, for an example, I have this website Snapdeal. You know, if I have to advertise, if I have to do promotion of this website Snapdeal is my client, then I go ahead and try to make advertisements for those. Try to make Google ads for my site Snapdeal, right? Do you see Snapdeal right up here on these? I can see Flipkart being there. I can see OLX, Mobile Smart, and Amazon being there. How would Amazon would have got its, this paid ad over here? We're going to start that today. We would be using a Google product called Google AdWords. We have plenty of various products which Google gives us. Can you name some of them, guys? All those products which Google gives. So we have Google Chrome, says Lena. Anyone else? Google AdSense, right? We have Android, right? Can I get answers from others? Google Analytics, says Dhruv, right? Google Analytics, says Saurabh, AdSense, AdWords, right? Dipankar, Chinmay, are you guys there with me? Can you listen to me? Saurabh says Webmaster Tool, right? Nitin, any other? Can you think of? So Google search engine, absolutely right. You have Google search engine, you have Google Mail, you have Google Maps. So many products are right up there, which are being given by Google for you to do plenty of other stuff. Now, Google AdWords is a product which is being given only to advertisers. When I say advertisers, all those websites who want to advertise and get their websites on the top, right? If you want your website to be on the top, you have to use AdWords. Very simple thing what you really need to do, guys, is first of all, have a Gmail account. If you have a Gmail account, then you can simply just go on to adwords.google.com and log into AdWords Google with the help of your Gmail account. Make sense, guys? AdWords.google.com. So, okay, I am already logged into a specific login. I'll just change that. If you're doing it for the first time, I'll showcase it to you. How does it look like? So let's say I take this one. I'm just writing down the URL which you have to take if you're doing it for the first time, adwords.google.com. I believe most of you are aware about this. If you enter adwords.google for the first time, right, it's the very first time it's going to ask you for your email address, the country, the time zone, the currency and all that. I'm going to change it because from India, I'm going to change it to Canada because I have a Canadian credit card. So you always need a card, you know, a debit card or a credit card to run these advertisements. Okay, once I do that, I select the currency, I go ahead, save and continue. Now, I hope you guys have got that the idea behind me opening Google AdWords. We have to create advertisement like these search ads, these paid search ads. If I want, you know, my ad, if I'm Amazon, I want an advertisement to be of this sort to be created and that too for this particular keyword, my ad should be appearing. How do I do that in detail? And what all settings are there? That's what I'm trying to do. Right. So I log into that. I'm going to be taking example of my own website, which is dmpathshala.com, this site. Probably I'll try to even launch the campaign and showcase the live campaign as well to you. So the very first thing, guys, which you have to do, I'm just curious to know whether Chinmay and Dipankar, both of you are able to hear me or not. You can type Chinmay and Dipankar on the chat box. Okay. Right. So you can create, the very first thing we have to do is create your first campaign. Click on create your first campaign. Now, before moving ahead with the first campaign, I want to make you aware of how does the overall AdWords structure look like. My voice is cracking. Is that for each and everyone? Is my voice cracking, guys? My voice is cracking. Okay. Let's try for just a second. You can't hear. Just give me a moment. I'll just try to fix this up. Yeah, and now it should be perfectly fine. Now I've connected to the better internet connection. So let me know in case you face the same trouble again. I'll try fixing this up. Can you hear me properly now? I'll just speak further and then you can get to know about that. So with Google AdWords, how does this overall process begin? With Google AdWords, how does this process begin? You know, whenever someone searches for a particular product on the search engine, that particular person is called a client. The one who searches on the search engine is a client. Client needs more traffic, the advertiser, the Amazon. Amazon needs more traffic on its site, right? For getting more traffic, they need more traffic because they would need more sales to happen on their site.
Excuse me.
Right? Makes sense. Amazon needs more traffic onto their site and those traffic should be converted into sales. That's the only way they can have more sales, right? In order to get more sales, you need to meet those people who are typing in those related keywords. Let's say, you know, we are 7 people at present. 6 of you type in buy iPhone 6. All 6 of you are actually looking to buy iPhone 6. You type in a keyword. And I am Amazon. I'm trying to connect with you guys. I have to be present here. So I have to make these ads. That's the basic, guys. Now, what Google AdWords does Google AdWords helps in creating this ad. Only Amazon would be using it. Six of you as users who are buyers of the product will never use it, right? Why would you ever use Google AdWords if you are just the normal search, normal people who are searching on internet? You would never be using Google AdWords. Google AdWords is always used by an advertiser or a website owner who needs traffic on its website and needs sales or leads. What do you think? What would be the objective of a site in terms of getting traffic? What would be the end objective? If it's an e-commerce site, it would be a sale. If it's a non-e-commerce site, what do you think would be the objective of a non-e-commerce site? Let's say my site. You know, Saurabh says to get leads, right? Anybody else? Lena says to get more visibility. Absolutely right. I can give you more example. If I want to brand awareness, says Dhruv. Absolutely right. Let's say if I want more signups along with not just leads, I want more signups for my webinar. I want more signups for my website, or I need some ebooks to be downloaded across. I can have all these objectives to be met. So we'll take this objective in mind. Let's say digital marketing Parshala needs more leads, then we would be creating, and from where do they need more leads? We'll cover that part. We'll start with that. Before that, like I said, client needs more traffic. Client is Amazon, and customers are looking to acquire various information. Customers are like all of you who are looking to buy iPhone 6. You guys search on Google, and whenever you search those queries, you press in those queries. These are called the keywords in the search bar. Ad would appear. Amazon would create those ads, you know, those search ads, in order to connect with the customers, which is going to be you, right? And they would appear on the right and the top. You already know that. I don't need to tell you. These are the paid ads, the one on the right and one on the top, right? Which are also called PPC ads, pay-per-click ads, the one on the top three and the ones on the right-hand side. They are 8 in total. And when it comes down to SEO, which we'll also cover in our overall, what do you say? We will cover in our overall course. We'll do the search engine optimization as well. Okay. So Google AdWords not just helps us in creating search ads, guys. It also helps us in creating image ads. So we'll cover that. And the video ads, right? So we'll do that step by step. The very first thing I want to showcase across to you, this is something which you will come across, is the Google AdWords structure. This is a very fairly important slide, guys. This is how a Google AdWords account is being structured. You have one single account. So I had this account which I have created just now. Every account has a unique customer ID. This is the unique customer ID, guys, and a unique email address and a password. So I have Google at dmparthshala.com. There is a unique password and a unique username along with the customer ID. So that's there on the top. Unique email address and a password. And then you have a billing information. I'll always need a debit or a credit card with the billing information. Underneath that, there are campaigns which we create. Okay, can you see a campaign name is being asked across by me? So let's say I want to create several different campaigns. Let's say I'm Amazon, giving you an example of Amazon. Amazon can have different campaigns like, let's try opening their website. How would Amazon classify their overall ads? They will dissect and manage their ads. They can have one of the So this is Amazon.com. So they can have one of the campaigns, let's say, as books and Audible. Another campaign as movies and games, movies, music. Another campaign as electronics. It's all about dissection. Can you see categorization is done over here? Then underneath every category, there is a subcategory. What is the reason behind doing creating a category on a website and then on a subcategory, having a subcategory, so that the end customer who is coming onto your site is not facing any difficulty in terms of accessing and navigating your website in going around and searching for a particular product. They can easily know if they are looking for clothing, for men clothing, let's say, they'll go to clothing first, then they'll see the men part. And underneath men, if they're looking for, let's say, a t-shirt, then they know that that's the path which they have to really follow. So underneath men's thing, they can select for from the brand wise as well. And men's clothing, shoes, jewelry, watches. I can go ahead and click on the men clothing part. And over here, I can select whether it's going to be jeans or pants or shorts. So the way it's been dissected, similarly, we dissect our Google AdWords. I'm just trying to make this point. You have, so forget about the account. This is always going to be one. Every website, every single unique domain will have a unique account. Every unique domain will have a unique account. And underneath that, there would be campaigns. So let's say if I do this as clothing, okay, this is one campaign is clothing and the other campaign is electronics. Campaign two is electronics. Underneath campaigns, there are various ad groups. Underneath camp, let's say this was clothing. I can have men clothing as ad group one and women clothing as ad group two, right? And similarly, if I have electronics over here in campaign two is being named as electronics. Underneath electronics campaign, I can have tablets as ad group one and mobile as ad group two. Every campaign, guys, has a daily budget. We can define on a daily budget. If I want to spend just 2000 rupees on one day, I can do that. I can define to what location do I want to show my ads to. If I just want to show my ad to Delhi NCR, I can do that. And I can target which language, whether it being an English or a Hindi or a French or a Portugal or whatever. And there is one thing called distribution preference. I'll come on to that. I can select when should my ad run, my entire campaign of the clothing one, which will have the men and the women, when it should start and when it should end. Why should we have end dates? Let's say I'm trying to promote across an event which is on 31st of December. If I'm promoting any event on 31st December, I myself go into that event and somehow I don't have time to I get busy with the party over there, with the event, and the ads keep running even after the 31st. You know, it keeps running for first or second. I don't get time. If I don't do scheduling over here, if I don't mention the end date, it will keep running and I'll unnecessarily keep on doing advertisement for something which is no more in existence. The event would have passed. The event would have gone, but I would have kept on promoting it. Wouldn't have made sense. It doesn't make sense promoting something which is no longer with you, right? So I can enter the end dates. Are you guys clear on this? One single account, you have campaigns. I gave you example of a clothing campaign being campaign one, electronics being campaign two. For every campaign, there is a daily budget. Just get that into your, recall this again and again. Daily budget can be set on campaign level. Location can be set again on the campaign level. Language again can be set on the campaign level. Distribution preference, I'll definitely tell you once we'll start creating a campaign and we can send an we can set up end dates, the start date and the end date. And then underneath every campaign, we have different ad groups. So in campaign one, when we have taken clothing, we can take men and women. And under electronics, we can take mobile and tablets, two ad groups. The idea is to dissect our Google AdWords structure also in the same fashion we have our website so that things are managed properly. That's the only objective. There should be relevancy right up there. Make sense? Are we clear on this slide? Can I move ahead? Can I get a yes or no from you? Yes, says Saurabh. Yes, says Lena. Yes, says Nitin. Yes, says Dhruv. Great. So, Nitin, I hope it's getting a good refresher for you. I'll move ahead. Yes, says Chinmay. Great, Chinmay. Thanks for letting me know. You can move your chat from private to everyone. You can do that. So as of now, I can only see your chat. So once we get to know about this, I am taking an example of, we'll start creating advertisements, Google ads for my website. In case you have any other website you want to do it, do it at your end as an assignment and showcase it to me, guys. I have already got some Saurabh and what do you say, Nitin, who have showcased across their advertisements to me, which I really appreciate, and I'll see to that more. Let's do that for my website. If I give in a campaign name to for my particular first campaign, I do it as, let's say, online class, or I want to name that as face-to-face class for Delhi Center. Okay, I'm gonna create it as like campaign one. I want to create it face-to-face class for Delhi, face-to-face class for the Ghaziabad version, and I have online classes. I can create another campaign as online classes. So I have three modes of delivering classes. So that's why I'm creating. I will be creating three campaigns. At present, once you name the campaign, you first of all, okay, I'll take the all features. Don't go with the standard one. Always select for all features. Okay. And always, as of now, go with the search network. We'll do the display network also. Go with search network only. Mention the campaign name and all features, search network. That's what. And go further down networks. It always has to be include search partners by default, guys. And your ad would be shown across on all the eligible devices by default. So whether it being a desktop or a laptop or a mobile phone or Apple phone or a BlackBerry phone or a Android phone, all the eligible devices it would be shown across. Now I just want to show across my advertisement to people who are based in Delhi. Okay, so I'll click on let me choose. I can go ahead and do, I can type in Delhi and I can add that, right? I can simply do that again. If I'm just trying to see if there is another option by the name of Delhi again. So you have Delhi, India. You have Delhi, California, Delhi, India. It's the same thing again and again. So I click on this. Delhi and New Delhi both. I click on this. I can click on this. Guys, there is another option which I want to tell you. That's called radius targeting. If can you see this button nearby? If I want to select certain locations which I am not aware of from their name, let's say I can click on nearby and I can just mention the kilometers and the radius targeting can be done. So within the radius of, let's say, 10 kilometers, I click on first radius targeting. I click on 10 kilometers and instead of miles, I can press kilometers. Okay, can you see this radius has come along? So it is measuring across from the center of India, of what do you say, Delhi, but somehow this is some other location. Strange, why is that so? Okay, no, just a sec. This is some other Delhi, I believe. Then let me just see. I click on nearby. Okay, this Delhi is right up here. I click on radius targeting and then I go ahead and press 10 with 10 kilometer being over here. I go ahead and press search. Strange, why is that? Why is it taking this thing? I have to press in Delhi. Right, so it says taken. Can you see? I pressed Delhi. I mentioned Delhi right up here and then 10 kilometers. It's showcasing me that this particular region, for this particular region only, my advertisement is going to be shown across. I'm happy with this. I don't want to go ahead with the entire Delhi. I just want to go ahead with this particular region only, 10 kilometers from the center. Okay. The bad part about the Google AdWords at present is that I cannot select the specific colonies. You know, had that been there, it would have been really great. But for other Western countries like, US, Canada, UK, Australia, that's very much possible. They can target with the help of the, what do you say, the postal code. So I go ahead and press done. That's one thing. I have selected the location. There's another thing, guys, which I can do. I can select, let's say, a particular state and overall state. I go ahead and select Uttar Pradesh. And within Uttar Pradesh, now the entire state has also been added. But if I don't, I want entire Uttar Pradesh to be covered, but not Lucknow. I want to remove Lucknow. I can select, I can type in Lucknow. And can you see that the exclude option? I can exclude a particular location also. So I want everything to be covered in Uttar Pradesh, but not Lucknow. I can exclude that. Make sense? I have written Uttar Pradesh, but I don't want Lucknow to be part of it. I'm removing it as of now, but that was just a way to let you know how does it work like. You go ahead with selecting the language which I told you, whether it's English or French or Indonesian or Hindi. I can go with Hindi also if I want my advertisement to be up on Google Hindi search engine. So there are Google's Hindi search engine also. I can create my advertisements in Hindi. I'm just going to showcase across for English, guys. That process is not at all difficult if you do it for Hindi, or if you do it for Urdu or Thai or Spanish. You can take help of Google Translate anytime. I believe most of you have done Google Translate. Use that. Next thing, guys, bid strategy. Now, what exactly is a bid? Can I ask you guys? I think most of you are quite aware of this. Why is this being asked across? How do we pay to Google? Right, so we do an auction, absolutely, Dhruv, right? Whenever we are paying to Google, we are paying on the basis of every click which is going to happen. Right, every click, whenever a visitor comes on to my comes on search engine, clicks on the ad, Amazon is paying for that, and Amazon is paying a particular price for per click, and that price gets defined by the amount they bid on that, they auction that, the overall rankings, Nathan, right? Total number of mount which you will be willing to pay for one click or impression. Absolutely. So one click, I would say, Saurabh, the impression part will come in the display one. Absolutely right. So if Amazon is saying I want to pay 100 rupees, I would be willing to pay 100 rupees, and let's say I am willing to pay 50 rupees per click, or 200 rupees, let's say. Jungly says I am willing to pay 200 rupees, and Amazon says I am willing to pay 100 rupees. You do the bidding part over here. I can select, I can say that I am ready to pay, 0.50 Canadian dollar. I can select that. Now, whenever there is an, click on my ad, I would be paying in 50 cents. That's quite a lot, but depends a lot on the keywords, what all keywords I'm going to be selecting. So just to let you know, initially you can set, don't let AdWords do that. Select manually, and how do you select on the default bid is with the help of one of the tool, you will get to know how much bid is there for the keywords you have selected. And that tool is called, guys, a Google Keyword Planner tool. Click on this and Google Keyword Planner tool. I'll come on to this part in a while. Okay, once you have selected the location, the language, the bid strategy, then the default bid and the budget. Let's say if I do it $10 a day, okay, just as an example, I can do that. And the delivery method. Now, this is the distribution preference which we were talking about. Can anybody tell me how many clicks would I would be getting in total in a day if I'm setting my default per click bid to be 50 cents and $10 to be my total budget for a day? For every day, how many maximum clicks? So Lena says 20. Anybody else? Dhruv, Nitin, Pulkit, welcome to the session, Pulkit. Chinmay, do you guys, can you guys tell me how many total clicks will I get if my budget is $10 a day and I am ready to pay 50 cents for one click? How many total clicks would I get in a day? Chinmay, did you guys understand my question? So Dhruv says 20, Nitin says 5. I repeat my question again, Chinmay, Pulkit. I am ready to pay 50 cents per click, okay? And total money which I want to spend per day is $10, okay? So how many total clicks will I get in one day with this budget? Pulkit says 20, Saurabh says 5, Dhruv changed his answer to 5, and Chinmay, can I get an answer from you? Did you get my question? Is Chinmay listening to me? Not really sure. So the answer is absolutely 20. It's pretty easy, guys. So with $1, I'm getting 2 clicks. So with $10, I'm going to get 20. So Dhruv, you were right earlier. I don't know why you changed your answer. So Saurabh, why did you feel that it was 5? I was saying that 50 cents, no problem. 50 cents for one click and total my budget is $10. So I would get 20 clicks, right? Maximum. So now, just to explain it to you, the delivery method, guys, if I do a standard, if I select on the standard or if I select on the accelerated, how is this going to affect? Let's say if I click on accelerated, guys, okay, my $10 would be used instantly or way too fast in an accelerated mode. This $10 thing starts at 12 midnight, okay? So at 12 midnight, when the day will start, $10 would be added on in my account from my credit card, okay? And my ad will keep on showing till the time I don't exhaust my entire budget, which is $10. So let's say if my ad starts at 12 o'clock in the midnight, until 2 o'clock, my ad keeps on appearing on search engine. I keep getting clicks on my ad. I keep getting clicks. By 2 o'clock, if my ads, I have got 20 clicks on my ad, it's good. After 2 o'clock, after 2 hours, it's going to go away. It will go away. Right? So because I have totally exhausted my budget, since I have totally exhausted my budget, so that's why it will go away. Now you might say, since this overall budget is pretty less, why should I be, you know, getting clicks only on that period of time, which is the midnight? Can I start? Absolutely, Lena, you can do that. If you do it like 12 o'clock or 2 p.m., you can set that. We'll do that. We'll do that in a while. So let's say even whenever you start your advertisement, you can start your advertisement at 2 o'clock midnight or 12 o'clock midnight. By default, it starts at that time. In 2 hours, it goes, it will use your entire budget. You don't want to use your entire budget within those 2 hours. You have a smaller budget. You want to use that entire budget all throughout the day. Then you do a standard. What will happen? Possibly after 2 or 3 clicks, your ad will stop showcasing. It will take some time. After a couple of hours, it will start showcasing again. So it will be distributed. Your ad will be distributed by Google automatically. Some of it would be shown in some part of the day. Another, then it will get paused, then some more clicks for another part of the day. It will be showcased across on all throughout the day, throughout 24 hours. So for the beginner, very good question, Dhruv. For the beginner, always go for the standard one so that you can get to know what time of the day is giving you good clicks. Sometimes, you know why this happens? The timing thing is being taken into consideration because, like the way we go into malls, guys, we generally do some shopping in malls, and it doesn't happen that every time we go, we come back with something or the other. We always buy in something. We sometimes become the window shoppers also, right? We just enter into the showrooms, check the stuff, and come back. In offline world, this happens. In similar way, in online world also, many people click on the ads, go to the website, check the various stuff they don't see, and then they come back. Now, whosoever does it, who's a window shopper, doesn't give us value. We always want our advertisement to be shown at that particular point of time when maximum prospective buyers are there and not window shoppers. It's a known fact that in the midnight hours for online shopping sites like Snapdeal, Flipkart, Amazon, most of the people who click on the ads or who come onto the sites, majority are online window shoppers. Okay, the window shoppers are majorly come in during midnight, and the major buyers, the percentage of buyers is more in the afternoon hours during weekdays, right? So if you have more buyers during weekdays and that too lunch hours, you will always want your ad to be running for that particular time. Make sense? Are we all clear on this? The delivery method, did I make you understand this? You want your ad to be showcased across for all the period for throughout the day. Your budget would be used throughout the day, then use standard. Otherwise, you want your budget to be used straight away without keeping into consideration the entire day, then accelerated. Saurabh says yes. So how about others? Welcome Sunil. Sunil, does that make sense? Pulkit, Nitin, Lena, Dhruv, Chinmay, the delivery method part is clear. Yes, says Dhruv. All good, says Lena. Thanks. Yes, says Nitin. Yes, says Sunil. Great, guys. Chinmay, Pulkit, have you guys got that? All right. The next thing, guys, which it's asked for is ad extensions. What do we mean by ad extensions? I'll just showcase that to you. When we have an advertisement up on Google search ads, we have certain extensions to it. Let's say I type in again, buy iPhone 6, one of my favorite keyword. I generally give example of this. Can you see the major difference in this particular second ad of which Apple has and this particular ad Amazon has? The major difference is that you have one click over here, another clickable text over here, another clickable text. So you have three clickable text in blue over here, and you don't have three clickable text over here for Amazon. Saurabh says site links, phone numbers, or other sites informations are absolutely right, Saurabh. That's right. So this is one of the ad extension. You have this ad. You know, this is an overall ad of Google AdWords, search ad. This particular line on the top, the blue line, is called a headline. Okay, this is called a heading. The one on the blue is called the heading. I'll come on to that, just letting you know. And the heading generally has the 50, 25 characters. So when I say 25 characters, I is one character, P is another character, H is third, O is fourth, N is five, E is six, and then space is the seventh character. So this is the headline, guys, and you have then description line one, which is this. The very first line in gray area is the description line one. I'm coming on to the ad extension, but I wanted to make you understand the overall parts of ad copy, what ad comprises of, and what are the limitations to it. That is 35 characters, description line one. So in this example, the Apple example, description line one is just learn more. They have written just learn more, which is not a good one. I really don't like this ad. And then you have description line two, which is this Retina display A8 chip and M8 compressor. Then this is description line two. And again, this has 35 characters. Are you guys clear on this part that every space, sorry, every character, even a space is being counted as a space is being counted as a character. I told you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. Seventh one, the space is counted as a character, right? So you have, you know, certain specifications for the ad copy, but ad copy does need to be there, but you know, these ad extension, this is called a site link extension. You can create these also. That's what it's asking me. That's what over here it's asking me, all the ad extensions. I'll take all of these ad extensions one by one. Very first one, guys, is location extension. So in case you guys have a location extension, a location extension gets a look. Have you guys ever submitted any business or your residential address on Google Business or Google Map? Try doing that with the help of Google Business. So that's the URL which I've already showcased, that if your web business is right up there on Google My Business, you can link that. I would try doing that right now. Let me see if it helps me do that. So I need to, I have a Google Business listing done from a different Gmail ID. I'll see if that can help me connect. No, it's saying it needs to be from that one only. I'll just try adding my Facebook, oh, sorry, my Gmail account from which I have added my Google Business. Guys, try to add on your particular location, your residential address with this, what do you say, on Google Business. So let's try doing this. No, I believe it needs to be from the same Gmail ID, then only it will help me do that. It's not letting me do. So whatever Gmail ID I have taken for being to be on the, what do you say, Google AdWords, from that same Gmail ID, I should have a page, a Google Business page. Earlier it used to let us connect. Right now it doesn't. So, but let me showcase how does it look like whenever new location extension is there. Let me show you how does it look like. Let's try searching for any hotel or a restaurant. Maybe they have some. Generally on phones, they have it. So at present, I don't see any advertisement for this keyword. So I have an advertisement for this keyword, but the location extension isn't there. Generally, location extension appear as this bubble, small little bubble. I'll showcase in an image, any of the image which is there. Right. So can you see within this particular advertisement, you have the ad copy on the top, then you have the description line 1 and 2, and then you have the destination, the display URL. The one in the green is called display URL, and then you have location extension. This is a location extension, guys. A bubble is right up here, and the address is there. And then you can, if you click on directions, automatically Google Maps will open up. All you need to do in order to connect this, you need to have a Google Business account with the same Gmail ID. Do you want me to do it with that same ID with I was with which I'm having my Google business account? Or is that okay? Right, it's not letting me do that. Earlier, it used to do some changes in Google My Business. Okay, let me see if this helps me do that. Yeah, it's not letting me do with my business account. It's not letting me help. Just trying some changes with this location extension. Earlier, this it was not like this. Okay, I need to have a business account and my Google AdWords account to be same. Then only it will help me. Can I move ahead? Are you guys clear on this? There's some restriction on the Google account. My business Google account, my Google business account should be same to what I am using for the AdWords account, then only the location extension will work. If I move ahead with site links are these extensions which I've already shown across to you. These, let's say, these three extensions, these three clicks which you don't have up over here, or these four clicks, these clicks are there of the inner pages. Can you see if I'm typing by iPhone 6, you're getting links for books, for mobile phones, for clothing and handbags also as an additional link to refer to. An additional link is right up there. Make sense? We can also create that. So let's try doing that for what we were doing. I'll just showcase for creating one of these site link extension. Right, I'll remove the location extension. Okay, strange, it's not letting me go away. So I click on plus new site link, guys. It'll ask me for the link text. Let's say I go ahead and do the DMP forum. I want to give a link to DMP forum, a DMP blog, and DMP jobs, and also the courses. So let's say I want to give this as another text. I can write link text within 25 characters as. Or just online forum. I can click on final URL, okay, and then have the URL for that. Click on mobile. I need that to be there on mobile as well. I can write a description. Right, I can do a scheduling. When do I want my citing extensions to be present and when do I want them to be removed? So I'm not pressing in any dates. I can start it from 7th or okay, let me do that. And I want them to be till 30th of September. Okay, this is majorly used when you have some events to promote across. You can do scheduling in terms of the timing also. When do you want this to be running across? I want only Monday to Fridays, and that too from let's say 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. That's when I feel the maximum traffic is going to come across. This is from my own experience, guys. But generally, you get to know when you first of all run it for all the days and all the time periods. When you run it for all the days and all the time period, then you get to know which time period or which day is more fruitful for you. We'll come on to that. And then forget about the advanced option. It's a new thing and it does involve certain coding. So not for you guys, it's for techie people. You click on save option. So one of the site link gets created. In a similar way, guys, I have to create at least three more. And the way it is going to appear like, I've already told you, they will appear like this. So I'll have a forum, online forum clickable link. And when I'll click on this, that particular URL will open, which I have already set. This URL will come over. Right? Are we clear on the site link, guys? Would you be able to create that for yourself? I would like to see your advertisement, which you would like to build for yours. Right? Saurabh says yes. Dhruv, Lena, Nitin, are you guys okay? Yes. Sunil? Right? Yes, says Sunil. Dhruv says yes. Okay, Nitin. Okay, Lena, thanks. So, in similar fashion, you can also have a call extension. Guys, location extension, like I told you, would only work only if your Google My Business account and your Google AdWords account are on the same Gmail ID. On same Gmail ID only it will work. So call number, let's say I want to do it. I press plus phone number. I select India. Oh, sorry. So where do we have India? EBCGHI right up here. And then I go ahead and enter my phone number, let's say whatever phone number I want. And I can mention whether I want the phone number to be present both on the website, both I want both my website and phone number to be present, or just the phone number. So I can select for both website and phone number, and that too on mobile devices. I have my preference. If I click on advanced, guys, I can do a scheduling for this also. I want my phone number to be present from this particular day, from 7th of June till 31st of August, and that too for what time to what time. So from Monday to Friday and from 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. right? And then I go ahead and press save. I would just like to showcase it to you. How would the call extension look like? A call extension very well looks well good on a mobile device. Whenever you open a mobile phone, you click on any keyword, you type in any keyword, you would get a call button like this. Have you guys experienced this before? This is a call extension, guys. You have an advertisement. So that's how it's going to look like for me also if somebody would type in on mobile phone the keyword. I would be punching in keywords for which keywords I want what ad. Make sense? The call extension. Have you guys experienced this before? Or something like this. This is a call extension, right? Okay, great. So I've done the call extension. I've created one of the site links. Location extension, unfortunately, I'm not able to create. It's fairly easy if you have a Google business account. So Google business accounts, you just have to enter your business account details. That's it. If you have a mobile app, you can also, link your mobile app in an ad extension over here. You can select plus new app. You can mention whether it's a Android app or an iOS app, and then mention the app, the app ID, the link text, whatever you want. Majorly, if just to give you an example, if you try it for try typing in Book My Show or Food Panda on Google mobile, Google search engine on mobile device, you will see a app extension of them, of Book My Show or Food Panda. Let me showcase app extension. How does it look like? Right, so that's how the Amazon app. You know, if you type in Amazon on a phone device, generally the app extensions are visible on the mobile phone device only. When you type in Amazon, that's how it looks like. It's going to look like get the Amazon mobile app. Make sense? So I'm not taking it right now because I don't have an app to showcase it across to you for DM Paathshala. Maybe in future I would have that, or Lena would help me do that, right? So next thing, guys, is reviews. Why I said Lena? Because she is into mobile app development. Next thing, guys, is reviews. What do we mean by reviews? Have you seen reviews on any Google page somewhere? So, yes, say Saurabh. Let me showcase. So I have my Super Digital Marketing Paathshala. I have my reviews. So let me showcase reviews for any other. Whose review should I showcase across? Every business has their own, what do you say, Google Plus page, and within Google Plus page, you can always have reviews being taken across by your audience. So you can showcase across your reviews also within your ad. You can see this is my Google Plus page, and I have 31 Google reviews right now. I can select to showcase across my Google reviews on my search ads. Now all these reviews can be right up there, and that's only possible if now this particular page is being linked to one of my Gmail account. Again, the Gmail account has to be the same. Right? The Gmail account has to be the same. I go ahead, press plus new review. Okay, I can even do it this way. It's not asking me for that. Just a sec. I can mention the URL. It was HTTPS text. So let's say reviews of digital marketing Pathshala. That's what I do, and then I can say source is Google Plus page, and I can do start and scheduling again for this. I'm not doing it right now. I can press save. Okay, it's not taking review sources ineligible. It's not taking the Google one. Strange. It should. It's not taking. So okay, probably if I have a third party reviews in my ads, I can show that. Let me try with Sulekha one I have. So I have reviews for this particular location. I can probably try this one, guys. Yellow pages, save. Let's see if it does that. Yes, it does. So my reviews will also be visible this way. And the last thing is the callout extension. This is something which is of no use. Many people don't use that, guys. It's just a small text which gets similar to a citing extension. I can create that, a callout text. Majorly, let's say something free you are offering, something special you are offering. Then you can write that. And you, these are not clickable. Okay, so I can write free demo classes. If I provide, I can have one more callout extension, let's say as a free website. I can have two callout extensions the way they appear. Very few people do that. I'll show you how does that appear. First of all, the review extension. That's how a review extension would look like. You know, the review would come up over here and it says who has written that. So it'll come as yellow pages or maybe this way. That's what other third-party sites are talking about you. Okay, so that was about the review extension, and the last one is the callout extension. So callout extension, like I said, it's a small text, guys, which is not even clickable, and something free or something attractive which you're offering. So like I told you, free shipping, 24/7 customer service, price matching, everything like this. Something extra, something unique which you are offering, you can have it on callout, but they are never at all clickable. These are not clickable ones. Can you see with this ad, guys, what all? Can you tell me which all extensions are used for this ad? The one which we have right up here. So I want to make it interactive. I want to know from you which all extensions are used in this ad. So the phone number, the address, right? Selena, I would say instead of address, it's a location extension. Instead of phone number, I would call it as a call out call extension. You said that right. So can Sunil, Dhruv, Nitin, which all extensions can you see? The map location, right? Absolutely. What else? Nitin, which other extension do we have? Dhruv says yes. What yes, Dhruv? Say that out. Other services, what other services? Which, what's the name of the extension which have been used over here? So Nitin, which all extensions have been used here? The call and the location, the site links. Absolutely right, Lena. Absolutely right, Dhruv. Great. So that's the thing. So when we'll also have, you know, the call and the location, all these extension up here, then that's how our ad is going to look like. Once we are done with this, after the call, all these extension on the campaign level, like I told you, we can schedule start. We can schedule our advertisement. I want my advertisement to start on 7th of June and it should run, let's say, till 31st of August. And I can even schedule it that my ad, my $10 thing. I've also seen social extensions such as Google Plus. Absolutely right. The Google Plus extension works with the review extension, but they have changed their, you know, this overall stuff. This social extension works with Google Plus. So the app, the call, the site link, the location, with review only, it used to work, Dhruv. And today, when I was trying to put in the Google Plus one, it was not taking. It should actually. I'm not really sure. I'll check on this why it's not. Yeah. So call out is there. And then, like I was telling you, I can do a scheduling of my ad. So starting from 7th till 31st of August, I can do an ad, on what particular time, for what to what particular time my ad should run. So I'll use my $10 on those particular time period only, and that too on a standard mode. Do you recall that? That standard mode, the delivery method. I don't want it to run just on an accelerated pace. It would be spent across, my budget would be spent across evenly all during the time I have selected. So it says spending budget evenly over time. So let's say if I am selecting 12 p.m. to 10 p.m., right? And that too between Mondays to Fridays, 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. That's what I do. And I do it for Mondays to Fridays. It would be standard thing. Ad delivery and ad rotation. This is something which I would like to tell you. We usually go for optimize for clicks. Initially, we want Google to identify that we should get clicks, right clicks from right people. An ideal setting would be selected by Google for this. Optimize for conversions won't happen right now because we have not, done the conversion. We have not applied the conversion part. And you can forget about these two. These are not used quite oftenly. This is the most effective one, guys. When you would be starting with the conversion tracking, I'll tell you, there's this particular tool called conversion right up here. You can select conversions. This will let us know that out of 100 clicks, how many clicks have resulted into sales or how many clicks have resulted into a lead. So let's say out of 100 clicks, 20 leads have come across. So it will show me that 20 leads have come. Google will select automatically where are these leads coming from what point, what particular geographic location, what point of time. And according to that, Google will optimize my ad. We'll do optimize for clicks. Once we'll run, after certain data is being, after certain data is being captured, gathered, then we will go for optimize for conversions. So if you're doing it for the first time, optimize for clicks. You can select the dynamic search ads in the campaign URL. These are some advanced level stuff, not the basic. That's something, from the coding level. Click on save and continue, guys. Now the next thing it's going to ask me for the ad group name. So the campaign name was the Delhi classes face to face, and if I name my ad group one, ad group one as let's say digital marketing classes, and I can start with a text ad first. I can write it as okay. Did I told you about the 25, 35, 35 characters thing? Do you guys recall that? This particular headline is 25 characters. Then you have description line one as 35. So you have 25 this, 35 this one, 35 this one, and the display URL, which is this one, is also 35 characters. The end URL, which is the destination URL, can be 1024 characters long. Anybody who knows a destination URL and a display URL, difference in destination and display URL. I have told some of you over here, probably, I believe. Okay, I'll just take that across. So when I am creating a headline, it has to be 25 characters. I have to make sure whatever I write over here has to be attractive enough. So let's say if I'm trying to tap in people who want to learn digital marketing. So I have just 25 characters. So it's all done. Learn digital marketing. So it's coming out to be very less for me. I can just play around with this and get it. Display character is of 35 and destination URL is absolutely right, Nitin. You got that right. So I write whatever it's coming to my mind, and maybe you can guys do it for yourself. You can take any website. If you have your own website, you want to do it, or you want to do it for any of your client or your workplace, try doing that for yourself. I am just typing in whatever it's coming to my mind. So I'm just thinking what to exactly type in. Right. Now, when I have typed in the headline, guys, the description line one and the description line two, what do we understand by a display URL and a destination URL? A display URL, let me showcase the difference in both of them with a live example. Let's say I go into Google. Okay. I believe Nitin knows that. I have told Nitin about that. Saurabh also would be knowing it. Sunil would also be knowing the difference in destination and display, right, Sunil? How about you, Dhruv and Lena? Are you guys clear, aware of the display and the destination URL? Just wanted to make sure. Wanted to understand whether you know that. Dhruv, Lena, you're clear on that? Okay. So it won't take much of my time. Let's see if I type in a keyword. Now the URL which is being listed out here, which you can see, is the display URL. But when I click on the ad, it will land to somewhere else. Can you see? Okay, the ad, the URL is going to come in a while. The URL, the actual URL where you have, where we have landed, where we, that's the destination where we have landed, is the destination URL. Now we cannot have such a long URL being part of our Google AdWords, right? It's a huge URL, right? My goodness, that's quite a lot. It should be 1024 characters. Now, the only similarity with display URL and destination URL, guys, is the first the domain. So let's say if I have to keep my, I have a landing page where I would like to put it across. I use this platform called instapage.com for creating landing pages, in case you guys want to use that. I'm just going to open the landing page which I would be putting across. Right, this is my landing page actually. So I go back and press my, I enter my display URL, and can you see it's not fitting in? It says 27 characters above. The only thing which I can do, something which is going to be common between display URL and the destination URL, is going to be the domain. It's going to be the domain name which has to be the same. Right, so the landing page, the destination URL, the final URL is the one where I want my viewers to actually go to. So my viewers would be going to this particular URL, right? And I click and I can change my display URL only the portion which is after the domain name. This would always remain common in the display URL and the destination URL, guys. I can name that as learn digital. That's it. So dmpathshala.com/learn-digital. So okay, this is something which is new. URLs for mobile. If I have a different URL for mobile, I have the same URL which works for it. I can mention that. Since many websites these days, I have created m dot version. So yeah, this Lena says display is shown under advertisement and destination is the landing page. Absolutely right, Lena. Yeah. So for the mobile version also it's the same, and add URLs option. Okay, leave that part. And the next thing which comes across is selecting of keywords. Can you see on the basis of the landing page, the final URL which I have typed in, Google has recommended me several keywords. Now, instead of using this keyword planner tool, which I would have done it initially, I have skipped that part. I'm not using this keyword planner tool. I'm using the keywords which are being given to me by Google on the basis of my landing page over here. So let's say I can choose which keywords should I be going in for. So it's a bit of a time-taking process. I have to see which one is going to match to what I'm trying to offer. So I'm trying to offer digital marketing training. Absolutely, digital marketing certification or certification. So I'm offering a certification and I'm also offering training. So I'm just trying to look for that. So possibly I'll go for these keywords, guys. So since I'm not promoting work from home and all that, so it doesn't make sense. I'm not trying to focus only on the AdWords part. Some digital training, so it says digital marketing training, absolutely right. Training courses, yeah, all of these are somewhat related. So I go ahead and click select these keywords, and the maximum cost per click which I have mentioned is 50 cents, right? So that's my default bid. I can change that as well. I can click on estimate search traffic. It'll give me how much traffic can I get. So the average CPC for these keywords is 22 cents to 26 cents. Now I can change my CPC, right? I had done 50. I can go ahead and do 24, right? Something in between. And the cost per day, it says, so these are all keywords with a default bid of 24 cents I have clicked on. I'm not too sure why it's showcasing 10 cents to 12 cents. Okay, this is something new. On the basis of my daily budget, it's showcasing that my per click cost can even go down to 10 cents to 12 cents. The average CPC is $22 to $26. But 22 to 26 cents, sorry. But if I have this budget of $10 a day, it can go up till 10 cents to 12 cents. So I go ahead and click on my maximum cost per click, 24 cents, and then I go ahead and save and continue. So I can set up billing later, not in front of you. Later on, I'll definitely set up my billing. You guys can also do that. It's showcasing me the first page bid. Now it has changed the bids. It's 55 cents. Or a 50 cent, I can change that 50, 75 cents. You can see it's doing that. Next thing, which guys, which I want to tell you is the keyword match types. I suppose most of you are aware of the keyword match types also. So it won't take much of a time. If I click on this particular tab, just right next to the keywords. Just right next to the keyword, if I click over here, I click on yes, I understand. It tells me three keywords: broad, exact, and phrase. Is everybody clear on this? I believe Nitin, I have told you, Dhruv and Lina, I'm not too sure. So Lina is clear. Nitin is clear, yes. Dhruv, are you clear on that part? Okay. So should I be taking this per topic, the keyword match types, or are you guys okay with that? Or I should move to the, you guys are okay. So, okay, fine. So what I would be, great. So what I would be doing in next class, instead of, repeating something which you guys already know, we would be doing the remarketing and the display part, or probably if you guys are done with that also, we can start with SEO also later on, if you guys are okay with the display part. But the very first thing which I want from you guys is to, I want to see your, we want to have display part. Okay, so next time, okay, I'm not okay with display. Okay, no problem. Sure. Okay, so next session, since if I'll start right now, it's almost 4:22, 4:23. If I'll start right now, it won't end up. Next session, we'll have display, but before that, what is placement and topic targeting? Sure, I'll take that. So placement is actually the website, the specific websites which we, if I want my advertisement to be up on shiksha.com, Lena, I can do that with the help of placements. And the keyword targeting is that, let's say if I select the keyword internet marketing training, so whatever websites who are taking in internet marketing websites, typing in content, having internet marketing training as a content on their website will place my ad. I'll take that in detail for sure. I have a small assignment for each one of you guys. Please send me across your customer IDs. I will add your customer IDs to my MCC account and I will see your advertisement. I want to see your advertisement being built upon. Sure, Lena, I'll definitely help you about whatever confusions you have. But we can start with display in our next session only. Right? Any further questions you have in related to the search ads which we have covered just now, the keyword match types and all that? The remarketing, okay, sure. Saurabh, enhanced CPC, okay. Enhanced CPC is a bid marketing strategy. So it's a bid strategy. So, okay, Saurabh says remarketing also. Sure, and Dhruv also says remarketing. Okay, I'll just do a refresh. I'll just tell you theoretically what remarketing is all about, but remarketing can be done only after display. Next class, we'll start with display and also start with the remarketing part. I'll just let me first go ahead and then tell you about the remarketing theoretical stuff, which probably most of you would be knowing about it. Hi, we have Vishal joining in. Hi, Vishal. Good afternoon. So, when we talk about display ad guys, which we would be covering in our next session, we would be doing display advertisements with the help. We would be doing remarketing only with the help of a display ad. Right. Saurabh, I'll also cover the enhanced CPC part. Enhanced CPC will only come after the conversion. Once we'll study the conversion part, how do we set up conversions? Enhanced CPC is just nothing but asking, Google to pay only for, pay only for the right leads which you would get, and you tell Google to pay more, even if by paying more you get a lead. So that's one of the bid strategy. Just trying to tell you a theoretical part of remarketing. Let's say you are a prospect. You are checking something on a particular website. Okay. When you check a particular website, you are somehow downloading the cookies of that website if they have a remarketing tag on their website up. When you leave that particular website, somehow it happens that you get to see that ad again. Okay, Saurabh, you say what is cost per acquisition? Sure. Cost per acquisition is also a part of the conversion. What is an acquisition? I'll come on to that also in next class. Just help me. We don't calculate it, Saurabh. The calculation for CPA is always done by the Google AdWord panel only. So like I told you, out of 100 clicks, let's say if we have got 100 clicks and out of 100 clicks, we have got 20 leads, 20 conversions. That means 20% has been my overall conversion, and overall 100 clicks have costed me, let's say 10,000 rupees. Then 10,000 rupees is the money which I have spent, and per click, per acquisition cost would be 10,000 divided by 20, which is almost 500 rupees. I'll come on to that part. Sure. So that will come all your questions, the enhanced CPC and your conversion and cost per acquisition is part of the conversion optimization. So I believe most of you are clear on the remarketing theoretical part, that you guys have already faced this in practical scenario, faced this situation, that whenever you enter a website, you leave that website, and when you have left that website on third party sites, on different sites, you get to see the advertisement of that website which you had visited a while back. Let me showcase with another example how it works. Let's say I visit this website, Saint Kitts. Okay, I visit this website, Saint Kitts. I'm trying to do some searching on it. I don't like it, or I have got something to do. I just close that. I close that, and after closing it, I am going on to 160x2 website. You won't believe, now this website will follow me everywhere through the help of banners. We can also do it the way Saint Kitts has done. And this is called remarketing, guys. I have visited a website. Now, after visiting this website, everywhere I would get to see their advertisements. Have you guys encountered this? Yes or no? And have you understood remarketing? Yes, says Saurabh. Yes, says Lena. How do we do this? Absolutely, we'll do this in next session. Many times you have observed. Lena says that. Sunil says yes. Nitin says yes. Dhruv says okay. So Dhruv, we'll talk about this in detail. That's a great thing. Just try creating the search ads first before the next session, before Sunday. Try to submit it to me by Wednesday or Thursday. WhatsApp me or email me across, guys, the customer IDs of your. So for Nitin, I have already, Nitin, you don't need to send me. Your ID is already linked to my account. You can just send me your customer IDs, okay? This particular customer ID. Otherwise, I need it from Sunil. Saurabh, I believe I have yours, but that got suspended somehow. You can create a new one and give me. And Vishal, you can also send me across your customer ID. Lena and Dhruv to you as well. Right, so any further questions, guys, for today's session? Yeah, you can give me a fresh customer ID, Saurabh, sure. Okay, Dhruv says no, no problem. So Saurabh, park your questions, ask me in next class, the enhanced CPC and the remarketing stuff. We'll definitely cover the remarketing. We'll start with, otherwise, any other further question, Nitin, any question, Lena, any other question, Vishal? Okay, no says Sunil, no says Vishal. Okay, Nitin, are you around? No, okay. No problem. So let's, my account says inactive. Okay, probably just try spending in like a, you know, couple of 100 rupees, Lena. Enter your details and try spending in $100 or something, and so that it gets you a feel of it. Right. So thank you so much for being part of Enter Details. Absolutely right. You need to enter the details. Thank you so much, everybody, for being part of today's session. And Saurabh, how to handle MCC account is very easy. Nothing else. I mean, okay, this time, Saurabh, you can create an MCC account. I'll tell you how to do that. it's not at all a big thing. The way you handle a small little account, it's I need to clear my sure, definitely. You can create an MCC account, right? Right? Should I wrap up or any further questions? So feel free to ask me, please. Otherwise, I'm going to be available on my email as well and on WhatsApp. So just connect with me on WhatsApp or email. We'll be in touch, guys. And let's meet to next Sunday, 3 o'clock, and we'll cover next Sunday. Our objective would be to cover display advertisements with conversion optimization and remarketing, right? So we'll cover that part. Perfect. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for joining in, and we'll meet ne next Sunday. Enjoy your Sunday, the leftover Sunday. Thanks, Mayan. Thanks. Bye-bye.